Oh my lord. Either way, Batt showing up with insanely dominant game one and game two. Gonna be going over to Blazing Hideout, one of Edelis's best stages.
I mean, I do believe Lichgo does quite enjoy this. I mean, obviously he's chosen it for a reason. But Batt already making quite comfortable work with the side B, demanding so much space across the ground that Lichgo just doesn't seem to have a way to answer for just yet.
Yeah, I mean, one of the things about Edelis is that recovery into characters like Shovel Knight, like Ori, is incredibly, incredibly difficult. And these side Bs are going to be able to keep your opponent off stage for forever, but if you're the one off stage, you're going to find yourself continuing to struggle if side B is your go-to.
Well, that was a very nice drift away from Batt there, recognizing that the Dunder was coming and drifting away just in time with the up air. But unfortunate DI from Lichgo will take the first stock, and right now, well, Lichgo actually has to play a little bit of catch-up.
Yeah, a little bit of catch-up, but shouldn't be too much after that parry. 122% on Batt, but the drop off of the platform, these dares, these F-strongs, doing so much work, and oh my lord, yet another parry coming on in. Batt is so ready for these icicle parries.
Forcing Lichgo high, Batt just had to wait for Lichgo to come down, just putting himself again in that comfortable position. We're nearly using the downer to take it off with an F-smash, but the down smash will take Lichgo's second stock at 122%.
Alright, and now Batt has the Ghost Gloves, has it all available, still hasn't thrown it out a single time. No double jump on the Shovel Knight, though, and dropping down, drop zone up air, as Lichgo finally going to be able to take a shot off of Batt, and Batt throws out the first 3, 4, 5 Ghost Gloves we've seen this entire tournament so far.
Getting good use of those Ghost Gloves, they're finally finding a good excuse. On a stage like this, why not? So much open space, very hard to command, but unfortunate SD. Very nicely done from Lichgo to avoid the descending
still no air
demon.
Dodge.
No air dodge just yet, but Batt actually has gone off stage, trying to find some sort of punish there, but none to be found as Lichgo now has the upper hand.
And Batt right now, you can see, seems to be a little bit more confused. You know, now that he's got the option of Ghost Gloves, seems to be like, oh yeah, you know, I got to use these, but it seems a little bit worse for the wear, honestly. And now off stage against Edelis, 97%, almost fully tied, no resources. Lichgo going to whiff the up air though.
Very nearly took it, and unfortunate DI on side B will be it. Batt takes it 3-0.
Oh, no, that should only be game two, actually.
Wait, was that game two?
That was game
two. I've completely miscounted. Blech.
No. To be fair, it did say game and set.
True, it did. Yeah. Yeah, I completely missed it because that felt like a game and a half right there. Both
it
games
did
have
feel
been
like
so
a game and a half
from S-Batt. But Lichgo still has another three games that he can try and bring this back. He's still got this game to try and figure the last few things out and get it on S-Batt, get the advantage that he needs to. And we're going back to Ethereal Gaze.
Yeah, but this time, not going to be starting things off with the side B towards Batt, but a side B away. And yet again, the side B parry punishes come on through. You cannot throw those icicles at your opponent, Lichgo.
I mean, I definitely know. Lichgo, I have spoken to him about this. He likes to have the plan, get them in the air, use the icicles.
No air dodge.
Not quite. But he's getting the opponent off the ground, then using the icicles. We've seen that so many times when S-Batt is down low, using the icicles to pop him back up, and then just grabbing him and dunking him into the blast zone. That's what Lichgo thrives at.
And right now, you can see Batt just racking up so much damage, so much extra credit, 18% right now, not too much just yet. But if we've seen this before, we've seen it again, and down air.
And that will be it.
Oh my lord.
S-Batt, you absolute monster,
no.
And currently,
no.
Lichgo very nearly took it from like that. What a disrespectful way that would have been to end it. But Lichgo yet again finds himself off stage with Dynamo Mail pushing him that little bit further off.
Yeah, and you can see Batt just playing so perfectly around these options from Lichgo. And the late up tilt leading into it all.
But the Donda will grab the icicles. The up smash coming through, not quite killing just yet. Shovel Knight, that would 100%. Lichgo can try and find something now. But the.
And the rock!
The rock is what takes that.
Oh my lord, the sweep will not be denied. And I know I did say I wanted to see some more of Super Dot versus Batt. And it seems Batt wanted the same. As Lichgo gonna be going down for third place, and Batt is going straight back up to Grants.
A rerun of the Titans, as we saw before, this was a super close game. And it kind of speaks volumes about both players' skill, because if Batt is a 3-0 there, and to go game 5 against Dot, it really puts in perspective the skill difference between some of the players. And they're all Amis, they're all insanely good, but just that little bit of finesse, just that little bit of figuring out what works, what doesn't, is enough. Create such differentiation.